In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a honeycomb coaster using Lightburn. So we're going to start by coming over to the hexagon or the polygon tool here. Click there, and then I'm going to hold the shift key while I draw the shape there. If you don't hold the shift key, you're going to get a distortion here. So make sure you hold the shift key down while you do it. And then I need to rotate it. So I'm going to select the select tool here. And you can see when I hover over the corners here, you get this curved arrow. So that allows me to rotate this, but I'm going to hold the shift key down again while I do this. And that way it clicks into place nicely for me. And I want it to turn it enough so that the points of this hexagon runs vertically like that. Okay, now I'm going to resize it. So I'm actually going to change to inches here. I like working in inches. So you just click on this option here to change to inches. And I'm going to make this 1 inch wide. So I'm going to type in 1, and that's a 1 inch shape there now. Now I'm going to need some more of these. So I'm going to use the grid array tool to do that, and that's on the left-hand sidebar. So if I click there, you can see we get this pop-up. And what I'm going to do is change the X and Y rows. So I'm going to go with 7 columns and also 7 rows. You can see the rows have gone upwards. I want them to sort of come downwards just to make it easy here. So I'm going to just reverse direction. Okay, and I'll move that out of the way now. So that's what we've got on the screen so far. Now I want to create some spacing between these hexagons here. So I'm thinking probably if I come over here to X spacing, I'm probably going to go with 0.2. I'm just going to put 0.2 in. Yeah, I'm sort of happy with that. I'm just sort of rounding it up. But you can move the up and down arrows, you can see here. And you can create greater or lesser spacing, but I'm just going to go with the 0.2. And then the Y spacing, I'm just going to leave that for a second, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to go shift by half here. So I'm just going to go shift by half, select that, and watch what happens. You can see now it's shifted across, which is just exactly what we need. And then I'm going to bring up the Y spacing until I get it to the same point as this one here, and that looks about right to me. Okay, so that's looking good. And I actually need another row there. I wanted 7, so that's fine, so I'll add that. So 7 columns, 7 rows. Now, I'm happy with how that's looking so far, so that's good to go. So I'm going to go OK. Now, what I need to do is remove some of these shapes. I don't need them all for my coaster. So on this first row, I only need 4 across. So I'm going to delete the first 2. I just select it and press the delete key on my keyboard. And same with the second one, and then the last one here. So I've left with 4, and on this row I need 5. So I'm just going to delete the first one and also the last one. And this row I need 6, so I'm just going to go with deleting that. So that's 6 there. This one I need 7, and then I'm going to keep all of those. And then I need back down to 6 again. Okay, so I'm going to delete the first one, and this one I need 5. So the first one. And the last one. And this row I only need 4. So we're going that one, and that one. Okay, perfect. So now all I need to do is group these. So I'm just clicking and dragging from the right hand side to select everything. And I'm going to right click and group. And I want to add an outline around here. So that'll be the shape of the coaster itself. So to do that, I'm going to come over to the offset shapes option in the menu here. Click there. And you can see it automatically adds an outline. I want it to be, I'm going to make it 0.2 because that matches the inside sort of line that I created. So we've got 0.2. And then your options are outward or inward or both. We obviously want outward. And corner style, now you can choose what you like here. You can go with round or a beveled shape. I think the beveled, you can barely notice any difference there. There is a slight difference, but not by much. But the one I want is corner. I'm going to go with this sharp sort of shape here. Don't have to worry about anything else there. And we go OK. All right, and all we need to do now is click and drag from the outside again to select everything. Right click and group. Okay, so that is actually complete, and all we need to do now is really change the width or the sizing of this. Now, coasters are around 4 inches, so they tell me, also Google tells me, so I'm going to change the width of this up here in the width and height section to 4 inches. Okay, so that is ready to go now. Okay, so I'll be cutting that one. That looks great. So thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed this tutorial, please give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel.